are looking at another class of invertebrates that we call molluscs. Molluscs. Yes, we have recently looked at coelenterates. We have recently looked at arachnids. We have recently looked at insects. We have recently looked at crustaceans. And this form, what we call arthropods. Arthropods. We have recently looked at sponges. We have recently looked at echinoderms. So right now, we are looking at molluscs. We are molluscs is double L. It is LL. There should be another L. Good. And then from molluscs, we shall look at worms. It would be enough to say we now understand what invertebrate animals are. Just by definition, that invertebrate animals are animals whose bodies do not contain a backbone. By definition, that an invertebrate is an animal whose body does not contain a backbone. So, today we are looking at molluscs. These are soft-bodied invertebrates. Soft. Bodied invertebrates. They are called molluscs. Body features of molluscs. Body features of molluscs. Number one, you have what you call a shell. Molluscs have a shell that, of course, protects it from, protects them from enemies, for protection against enemies, for protection against enemies. These are molluscs with a shell. The molluscs have what you call tentacle. A tentacle is an antenna-like structure on the head of molluscs made for detecting change in temperature. Change in temperature. That's one. Two, detecting sound in the environment. Three, it is meant for detecting smell. Detecting smell. So the three functions of the tentacle is that the tentacle detects change in temperature. Secondly, a tentacle detects sound in the environment. And lastly, it detects smell in the environment. Where do molluscs commonly live? Molluscs commonly live in seas. Molluscs commonly live in fresh waters. They commonly live in seas and fresh waters, plus land. Some live on land. These are two examples of molluscs that live on land. Let's look at examples of molluscs. Examples of molluscs. Examples. These include cuttlefish. That's number one. Number two, we have octopus. Number three, we have freshwater snails. Then we have squids. From squids, we have slugs. Then we have oysters. You can add on here garden snails. So you find that garden snail, slugs, and squids, these live on land. Then the oyster, the octopus, live in seas. Then freshwater snail and cuttlefish live in fresh water. Those are molluscs. Let's look at the dangers of molluscs. Are they dangerous in the environment? Yes, indeed they are. And what is the danger of these molluscs in the environment? Why should we get rid of these in the environment? Number one, we shall see that molluscs are disease vectors. Dangers of molluscs. It is disease vectors. They are disease vectors. Yes, that's true. And the disease they spread is bilharziasis. They spread bilharzia. This bilharzia, meaning they spread a germ. This germ is a worm that we call schizosome. We call schizostosome. This is a worm, schizostosome, responsible for causing bilharzia. And this schizostosome is carried by the molluscs. And this mollusk is freshwater snail. So freshwater snail spreads schizostosome, which causes bilharzia as a disease. Bilharzia affects the kidney. It's a very dangerous disease. Yes. So it is not advisable to bathe dirty water, because this is where the freshwater snails are found. Thank you. Like the video, share it, subscribe to my channel. We can teach ourselves. Thank you.